What is happening, guys? Welcome to a new Let's Play on the channel, The Last Story. This is a game by Hironobu Sakaguchi, the creator of the Final Fantasy series, though this is a Mistwalker game. He did leave a few years back, and now he's creating brand new masterpieces. Of course, The Last Story, as a name, is very equal or even or very similar to Final Fantasy, if you know what I mean. Now, the music score by Nobuo Uematsu, another very famous name in JRPGs, and that is, of course, the general composer for most Final Fantasy titles. He's just amazing as well. So, this game has great pedigree. Now, this game is not out in America till past the summer, so all American viewers, you cannot get this game yet. It has been, rushed towards the EU shores. The first localization was for the EU, which is really good for me, because, of course, I get the game early, and more to the fact that all the voice acting is done by people on the British Isles. So Welsh voices, Scottish voices, which I think really, really goes well with the fantasy genre. And this isn't really a typical JRPG anyway. You'll see what I mean when I say the battle system, it's kind of a cross between, like a traditional JRPG, the turn-based battle, kind of strategic combat, but also real-time battle with, say, like Fable and Gears of War a bit in there as well. A bit of influence of that is, it's also like a very previous Final Fantasy game called Crystal Chronicles to some extent. And this is what brought my attention to it. It made me want to play it. It made me want me to bring it to you guys. So we're going to do the last story, the entire story. I hope you guys enjoy and buckle down and let's get going. Right then. Annoying little screens that always tell you what you're doing. Petals floating around. Any kind of starting cutscene, I wonder? No such thing. So we're getting straight into the game then. So it's very atmospheric, very dark game, and the graphics are pretty standout for a Wii game. It shows you what a developer can do if they actually give a crap about the Wii console as a whole, rather than just make rubbish little gimmickware. We're in the menu, new game, let's get going! Straight into the action! Right then, straight into the action. This would be what a TV would call a cold start. New tutorial. General movement. Movement of camera. You use the control stick to move. Press C to reset the camera. That's a traditional kind of like Zelda mechanic. Same kind of button setup. And it has video tutorials as well. Press C to reset the camera. Nothing we don't know. I have to skip it. And there's a little something I know just from looking at a little bit of trailers of the game. And that is that there is a rare item hidden at the very, very start. And this is about all I know about the game, apart from, you know, things I've read. So let's pick it up. And that is basically all the cheats of guides I'll be doing for the entire playthrough. So let's head straight out there. Of course, you heard the lovely English accents of Siren there. You guys like my English accent by a lot of the comments out there. You're going to be full of them. Full of British accents for this playthrough. Let's get going out there.
You never said we'd be playing tag.
Just do your job.
By your command.
Think of the money.
I'd rather think of the bee you're gonna buy me with it.
Only if you get more of these things than me.
All right, it's on. Try not to fall too far behind, eh?
You have a monstrous ego there.
Then you can look forward to my monster victory.
Man, I don't think I should talk over any of these cutscenes or chatting. New tutorial. Alright then, when near an obstacle, press A to hide. Press A again to emerge from cover. So this is like the Gears of War kind of ish system. It's got a cover system, but it's also got some shooting as well. The control stick tilted up, press A to vault. Hold down B to vault even while moving, which is handy. Let's go. Oh, holding down B would probably be better. Guarded that shot. Come back here, mate. Me and you've got a date with destiny. Or more to the point, you're deaf. That guy got cut off, didn't he? No, where'd he disappear to? I thought he was the only one guy that escaped. Some kind of battle then. Alright then, basic fighting. Use the control stick to move towards the enemy and attack. You can press minus to open the menu and change the attack type to manual on the options screen. So this isn't like it's real-time battles, so like Fable, you would walk up and smack a guy lots of times, right? But it's not in the sense that there's a lot of strategy involved and there's a lot of playing off party characters. In most games, you would be the main damage dealer on pretty much all of them. That's where developers think you get excitement from. In this one, it's got a little bit of a twist on that. You still do damage, you are a damage dealer, but you're also like what an MMO would consider a tank. You're very much the crux of your teammates' ability, well, like survival, and you're very much playing off of what they do as much as anything else. So you can set it to just a button bashing attack, but it's actually kind of advantageous to keep it on the just move towards an auto attack. Right, guarding. You can guard during battle by holding B. While guarding, damage sustained from enemy, physical, and magic attacks is greatly reduced. And here's a little video guide. Use a control stick to move to the enemy and attack. No problemo. We've already been doing that. Press B to guard and face the enemy. That's like a camera center and guard. And while guarding, press B to Z to lock onto an enemy. So Z targeting, you know, traditional Zelda mechanic. Traditional Nintendo mechanic, more to say. Let's get out there and kill some of these reptids. I guess we should fight back to back, really. We should stay around each other. While there's guys out here like that. We can dive as well, using the A button. So dodge and duck and dive. We've got a chain then, by both attacking at the same time. Oh, we're critting for days. I'm critting everyone.
Watch your back.
Doesn't like looks like she needs it.
They just keep on coming. Damn! What the hell is Zale doing?
Yurik, let's move. You think Dagrin and Serena are ahead?
Yeah. Let's go and find them.
Okay, moving on to different characters. Your current progress has automatically been saved to the checkpoint save. Okay, that's cool. Bad guys.
This place is crawling with these things. What do we do? I don't think they've noticed us yet.
Okay, hold down Z to enter seek mode. If there is anything to find, the seek icon will flash in the bottom left of the screen. So there obviously is.
That pillar.
Okay, we can destroy it or leave it alone. Well, what are we going to do?
We destroyed.
Yurik, hit that pillar with your magic.
Okay, he's channeling.
I see. I'll give it a shot.
So we got environment destruction as well.
Zale, it's the Reptid's horn. Dagrin and Serena have messed up.
Yurik, let's go. No one's dying while I'm here.
Wait! Today I'll rescue you, Dagrin. I'm pretty sure those two can look after themselves.
They're my friends. I can't just sit here.
I'm not really into...
They're close. I can hear them.
Zale, stop. Don't get carried away.
Alright, we got four party members now.
That's a lot of reptiles.
Okay, more Z things. Well, it worked last time.
Yurik, destroy that bridge.
I don't know. It looks pretty tough.
Just do it.
Yurik!
Fine. Don't blame me if it goes wrong.
Bye-bye, Bridgie, bye-bye. Let's go! Siren's probably not looking too healthy there, but hopefully we can kill anyone before Siren goes down.
Yurik, use our brain sometimes. Not like Siren here.
Oh, we got some level ups. Of course, Jurek did a lot of the damage, considering he just flattened guys no problem. Come on, Jurek. Get over here. Where are we going next, then?
What? Really?
Really?
Zael, surrender. Protect Yurik as he's casting.
Okay.
Okay, understood.
I'm counting on both of you.
Or we could just let the reptiles.
Don't hit him!
Take him off our hands.
Protect him! There we go. Okay. Oh, I really should have got out of the way there or guard it. Oh, smack down! Okay, attacking the enemy using an elemental weakness.
Well, we looks like the coast is clear.
Just killed him in no time.
Right. Is everyone okay?
Yeah, that was easy.
Let's move on.
Yeah, more than okay.
Looks like we have a new client.
Woo! All right! Just as we're about to run out of money, too.
Thanks to someone getting hammered all the time.
Shut it! I risked my life out there. Let me drink in peace.
So, may I ask who our next client is?
It's Count Arganon.
Wow. The ruler of Lazarus Island. That's quite a result.
There's a huge cannon on that island. But all that magic is dangerous. It draws all kinds of monsters to the area.
And we have to clean up, right?
You have a problem with that?
Mm-mm. As long as I get paid, I ain't complaining.
Yeah, right.
Anyway, I reckon it's time to celebrate. Barman, here's with the best you've got!
Okay, some kind of flashback scene. Some of them are epic accents. Save points.
Take a good look. Some of them can use magic. Zael, go and flank them from the right. At your signal, we'll charge from the front.
Got it.
We'll finish this before they know what's hit them.
The healer in the center will cause us some grief. I want this fast and clean.
So as you can see, are different from many games. We've got some kind of like strategy setup where we see the enemy formation. We're over here, they're all facing us. And I'm going to go flank them, kill off these guys, at least one of them, if not both. So let's get going.
Leave it to me. I'll flank them from the right.
They've got lookouts in position already.
Tutorial. Okay, using the crossbow, enter seek mode, Z, shoot, zoom, select arrow type, use the crossbow to attack distant enemies and interrupt the casting of enemy mages. So if we got any spellcasters going on and they're casting from a distance away, just quickly whip out the crossbow, hit them in the face, interrupt them, it's good. No visual showing you how to do it this time. As you can see, a bit of Gears of War cover play and shoot-sting action. Shoot-sting. Right, so we should be behind them now. Right here. Hey, we got the Wizard Slayer arrow, which of course should do a lot more. It's a weak point, it says. Do I have to press plus to see its weak point? Ah, a Repted Mage uses healing magic, weak against fire, so we can see through the seek mode. Let's just shoot him one.
Now.
Oh, there's the Ever Mage, nicely done. Both of them out in no time at all. Now we're just drilling through the rest. On the magic comes in from Yurik. Completely flattens the run running away. More level ups.
So, how the hell are we supposed to get over there then?
I'm pretty sure this has something to do with it.
What does this do?
Who makes something so dangerous? It's totally irresponsible.
I'd say it definitely looks man-made.
Okay, random cutscenes, things falling from the sky, man-made, but look at all the little cover blocks as well. Man-made to the perfect extent.
Dagrin, I'm hungry.
Let's try to be professionals, okay?
What? If I'm hungry, then I'm hungry. If I get killed because I'm too hungry and weak to fight, then don't blame me.
If you've got the energy to whine like that, I'm sure you'll be fine.
Very nice conversation there. Okay, dead end, but we can check this.
Any luck?
I can see light.
Hey, try giving it a little tap. You don't mess around.
This just never ends.
Wasn't really a little tap though, was it? It was full on kick.
Where are we?
Some kind of ruins.
It's cold, it's weird, and it stinks. I don't like it.
I can definitely target these guys, and they definitely look like the type that's going to come alive on you. Skeletons in a place like this generally means badness. Where are we headed, guys?
A dead end.
Yurik, let's look for an alternate route.
Hey, shouldn't we stick together?
No. It's easier to scout with fewer people. Zael, Seren, you two rest while you can. I'm sure there's more trouble waiting for us.
Zael, keep your pants on. You better get some rest while you can.
I can't help it if I'm worried.
Dagrin can look after himself. Or are you getting all scared because he's not here to protect you?
What? No! I'm a grown man, Seren.
A grown man, are we? How big and macho. Well, I guess you have grown up a bit. But you're still just a kid to me and Dagrin.
What was that?
It's just the wind. Don't be such a chicken.
Doesn't look good to me. God damn.
Today is not my day.
It was expected, but still scary.
You're this big, manly man. Dagrin never told us about these things.
I can hold them!
Wait.
None of you guys are going to get hit from me.
Zael, in here, now. We can buy some time.
Okay.
What the hell are you doing? Move it!
I was defeating all the enemies, even though it looked like they got back up in the end, to be honest.
I said move! Look, not much further. Keep it up!
Okay. Following.
I'll come up here. You search for another way out.
Guess I'm searching for another way out then, madame. This door is sealed by the curse of the undead, that's not handy.
You search for another way out.
No good. Damn, a dead end.
Looks like this is it.
Well, that's not good. Let's put it that way. All of a sudden, already one of your friends dying is never good.
Seren!
Mommy.
Mum! Seren!
I don't want to be alone anymore. I'm sick of it! Sick of all the pain!
You can hear my voice, yes.
What is this? Who is it? Who's there?
Your heart is like mine. Filled with loneliness and sorrow.
Who? Who are you?
If you wish to protect those who are precious to you, then pray for it with all your heart and soul.
Okay, with some random ability gifted to us, we've got Sea Gathering, all the enemies are standing still, so may as well use it and find out what it does.
What's going on? Protect those who are precious to me. What does it mean?
Oop, revived her. New tutorial, better check that out. Gathering. This ability forcibly draws enemy attention. Press C to activate it and C to release it. The speed reduction of an enemy targeting Zell is shown by the number of triangles above its head. So this is what I'm talking about with the tanky function. You're more a tank, a focus of enemy targets, allowing your allies to do whatever they need to do and then playing off them. You'll kind of find out how this develops. I've read about it, I haven't really seen it in action, so it's kind of like doing what I think is right. The focus of an enemy is indicated by a beam of light called a target line. The type of enemy can be determined by the color of its target line. Okay. Cure. While gathering is active, Zell can revive incapacitated allies by touching them. So, just what we did to Siren there. Allies revived by cure receive a temporary boost in ability. So stats, cool. Tip, an ally incapacitated 5 times will be KO'd and unable to be revived. So permadeath or something. Let's just kill everything. That'd be what the white circle is then, above Siren.
Zale, this is weird. Really weird.
I'm just as confused as you are. I heard this voice in my head and...
What the hell is going on?
Here goes!
These things don't stay down.
Some people say the undead are given new life in the underworld.
I've heard that somewhere before.
They do say fairy tales and legends have a ring.
What just happened?
What? There was a way out. Zale, you useless idiot.
Sorry. I didn't know. I couldn't open it. It was a curse of an undead. Why are you having a go at me? Yeah, that battle was kind of odd then. It basically draws every single enemy towards you, allowing you to be the focus, you to move around and kite them if you want to, if you know that terminology. Just to drag them around the area and make yourself it. If you're playing a game of tag, as you know what I mean? So all your allies can cast spells, big attacks, just DPS as much as possible. Now it's gonna like evolve into more later on. I've read about like the combat system, but again, don't know exactly how it will go or the storyline or anything. So we're gonna find it all out. Thank you for joining me for the first part of the last story. That sounds really odd, the first part of the last. Tune in for more, subscribe to me, subscribe to the show for the entire playthrough, and I will see you guys around. Cheers for watching.